Marisa Scalera. I am a landscape architect here with Smithsonian Gardens, and I had the great pleasure of being the project manager for the Habitat exhibition. We are standing here in the Life Underground exhibit. This exhibit invites the visitor to consider the ground beneath their feet, the soil, the dirt, as a habitat in and of itself. So that soil, that dirt, contains a vast network of organisms that are thriving in the ground. We particularly, in this exhibit, highlight the mushroom. You may or may not know that the mushroom is just the fruiting body of an organism that has a vast network of thread-like mycelium, or hyphae, that are the body of that organism, and that connect that organism with two plants, allowing plants to chemically communicate with one another. And it is that interconnection that we want to explore with this exhibit. This exhibit is one of the first that we began the design process for. We reached out at the beginning of our planning process to a local artist, Poon Cham, who's a professor at the University of Maryland. He's a very energetic man, full of enthusiasm, and he was a joy to work with. When we initially reached out to him, we asked if we could commission him to build a sculpture for us, design and build a unique sculpture for this exhibition. And the result is what you see here today. This is a 14-foot diameter mushroom sculpture. One of the unique things about this sculpture is that all of the wood for it is sourced from our own Smithsonian Gardens campus. So anytime that, within the 2-year planning process for this exhibition, anytime that a tree was sick and had to be removed, or that a tree had to come down for a construction project, we took that wood and we salvaged it all, and we had it milled, and it got incorporated into this sculpture. So you see here today a sculpture that includes bald cypress trees from the Air and Space Museum campus. It includes katsura trees from the Natural History campus. It includes some oak trees here from the American History campus. Visitors to take away the same big idea and key messages that are threaded throughout the entire exhibition. Protecting habitats protects life, and particularly invite visitors to consider unusual places as habitats as well, such as the ground beneath your feet, and to think about how those unusual places, those unusual habitats, are also homes for organisms, and how they provide a place for these interconnected networks of living organisms.